almost didn't make it, I almost didn't last. Why does the week go by so slow, the weekend so fast? But luckily the day's come to take my cares away. It's not Sunday, Monday, or Thursday, that's right, it's Friday, Friday. Tonight I'll party with my friends. Friday, Friday. Today I know the weekend. So I'll get out of bed and be to work on time. I'll give the state of the company the next 2 days of mine. Through my day's over and the final work hour's passed, I'll go home, have a shot of Cuervo to the boss who can kiss my Friday, Friday. Tonight I'll party with my friends. Friday, Friday. Today I know the weekend. Friday, Friday.
Yeehaw! It's Friday, bitches. Enjoy yourselves.
No?
Yeah, absolutely. Oh my gosh. I'm so feeling this Friday. This Friday is needed. This Friday, this weekend is needed. Yeah.
Lots to get to this morning. Shaw, of course, in the newsroom. Three ways, bad news, happy music. Doc will join us later on to talk racing. The time change happens this weekend, so we'll give you some tips on other things you should do.
And it's raining out.
And there is some rain in the forecast today. Yeah, at least here in La Crosse. I don't know if it's going to be heavy, but it's raining already.
Showers are going to stay mostly south of Eau Claire, so kind of in the I-90 range with maybe about a half an inch, but otherwise a little bit cooler in the 40s. Some areas are going to see sun or a little mix of clouds and sun, but raining right now.
Warming up, though, looks like 63 on Monday, maybe even to the 70s, excuse me, on Tuesday. We'll get to Blink-182, and we'll talk to Shaw in just a bit.
More of your rock mornings coming up in just a bit.
Bow, 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 bow. Scott Robert Shaw. Bow, 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 bow. Bow, 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 bow. Bow, 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 bow.
That's a lot of papows.
That's a lot. Papow.
It's pretty early for that.
Papow.
It's way early for that.
Wow. When you do something on this program that becomes popular for some strange reason, and then you go out and you run into our listeners, that's the only thing they want to talk to you about.
Is that right?
Much like the letter E situation that we had a week ago, where all of my friends at the bar were telling me that the day we did the letter E thing, they had a paper, a full entire paper full of E's that they were writing
and this
along
is...
with us while we were doing it here in the studio. And then yesterday... I heard more raw Shaw than I've ever heard in my entire life, and I don't think I ever need to hear it again.
Yeah, I'm good, too. Let's let that one go.
It's like the only word they know that rhymes with Shaw is raw.
And I don't like that one. I think we're passing on that one, Shaw.
Yeah, I think so, too.
Oh, we are certainly passing. I did like the news one that you dropped yesterday.
Yeah, a listener had suggested that. You've been newsed.
You've been news.
Reminds me of Seth Rogen in Pineapple Express. You've been served.
But I think on Monday we're going to start Prestige Worldwide.
If you want.
I think that's going to be hard for you.
Yeah, it doesn't exactly flow that well, but, you know, it stands out.
Well, just try a few out for size and we'll see what happens.
Okay.
Okay? I'm just letting you know that I took all those bullets for you guys yesterday.
Thanks.
You're welcome. It was.
People have lots of ideas, huh?
Oh, yeah, they're great. I love hearing them in person while I'm trying to focus on my $4 spins on the spooky machine. It's
yes,
great.
For sure.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's good.
I'm Scott Robert Shaw, drinking the claws. How's that one? That one rhymes.
Ain't no laws when you're drinking
claws.
I think Jesse James Dupree has a patent on that.
Yeah, probably.
On the papow trademark. Yeah. Anyways. News, what's going on? State of the Union, did he fall down? Did he look lost like a Roomba, or what's his sitch?
You know, I didn't catch all of it. I caught some of it, but he seemed...
I heard fiery. I heard the word fiery.
Yeah, he was wound up.
What, they give him some good stuff, or what?
Maybe a shot of dopamine before he got out there. Yeah.
What, did we get, a little pick-me-up or something?
I got a lot to get done.
What, do you have a really nice ice cream cone before he went out there? He likes ice cream, right? That's his deal. Is he a biter or a licker when it comes to the ice cream?
I couldn't tell you.
I don't want to know.
People who bite ice cream are like psychopaths. When you're eating it out of a bowl, that's one thing. Don't get me wrong. Your teeth are involved. But if you've got a cone and you're like
chomping on it.
Dude, there's something wrong with you. Legit.
I'll take an ice cream biter over the crazy E person. Three lines and then a down one anytime.
Right? Well, President Joe Biden delivered a defiant argument for a second term in his State of the Union speech last night, tearing into GOP frontrunner Donald Trump for espousing resentment, revenge, and retribution, and for jeopardizing freedom at home and abroad. Biden repeatedly delivered broadsides at my predecessor without ever mentioning Trump by name. The scrappy tone from Biden was a sharp break from his often humdrum daily appearances and was designed to erase doubts about whether the 81-year-old is still up to the job.
All right, he got it together for like 1 hour, right?
68
let's
minutes.
Let's reel it in here. I can get it up for 68 minutes, but the rest of the week I'm going to need some naps. You know what I mean, Sean? I'm going to need, you know, a couple of laydowns here.
Well, as he probably does as well. He's 81 years old.
Jill's probably like, okay, now let's get you to bed. Come on, over here.
Come on, Matlock's on. A lacrosse man suspected in a Northside shooting is asking for a speedy trial and a court-appointed attorney. Linnell Carter was arrested in January and charged with attempted murder for allegedly shooting another man in the leg during a dispute. During a court hearing yesterday, Carter suggested he had been threatened by the victim in the incident. Carter's bail remains at $500,000. He has another hearing set for March 20th. Tenants who face eviction in La Crosse could get more help from City Hall to avoid becoming homeless. A city council committee has approved $60,000 in funding for an eviction defense project aimed at providing legal help for families who could lose housing. The money largely comes from leftover federal ARPA money that was sent to the city. Friendship and teamwork are valuable in everyday life and in areas like sports and scouting. Packers Hall of Fame player Antonio Freeman spoke about friendship in lacrosse yesterday as a guest speaker at the annual Golden Eagle Gala for area scouts. Freeman promotes hard work and team effort among young people and encourages them to achieve good things.
Just give them encouragement that anything's possible. You know, you might have to change your major. It's not the worst thing in the world. You know, there are going to be changes in life that happen through your journey, but embrace them and don't be afraid of it.
Freeman was a Cub Scout as a kid in Baltimore, but says he didn't make it to the Boy Scout level. He played with the Packers, Eagles, and Dolphins during his NFL career and was part of the Green Bay team, which won Super Bowl 31 in 1997.
Did he lie to his parents to get his badges like I did?
Like you did? Yeah, I did that, Mom.
There's only a couple of them.
Okay.
Look, if your parents are as disinterested in your life as mine were, you can get away with a lot of stuff like that. Yeah, sure, whatever, kid.
I think he maybe really was a Boy Scout. I think
he actually
sounds
did
like
the knots.
I think he did.
He was a Cub Scout, but didn't make it to Boy Scout.
Oh, Cub Scout.
I just wanted to burn things. That's all I wanted to do. If there was a section of that Boy Scout book where it was like, steal some of your dad's gunpowder and try to make a pipe bomb. If that was in the book, I would have shown proof of my work. I would have been like, yeah, show an example. Here you go.
Give me that badge.
My badge.
Yeah, give me that pipe bomb badge. Dude, gunpowder's fun when you're a kid. Especially the first time you realize. Because, like, you know, when you're a kid, you don't really get it. I just knew that it was dangerous.
Mm-hmm. And my dad and it might blow up.
He kept it locked up, you know, in the back room where he did all his bullet reloading and all that stuff. And, you know.
Turns out it is dangerous.
And then one day he left it unlocked, and I was like, ooh. There's all sorts of fun stuff in here. Yeah, very dangerous. Nearly burned down an entire forest.
Whoops.
Well, people used to throw their old Christmas trees in the woods behind my parents' house. And there, you know, there's like, I don't know, there was bike trails back there and there's train tracks and then there's a river back there with a boat put in and all this. Anyways, so we would ride our bikes back there and people would just throw their Christmas trees. And then when they get really dead, we would take them all and put them in a pile or line them up along the railroad tracks. And we squirt them with lighter fluid, which you didn't really need to do, but it just
made it more fun.
Yeah. And light them on fire. And then one of the trees escaped and rolled down the hill and ended up in the woods and started a small brush fire. When you're a kid, you're like, should we run? I don't know.
Yes.
No, we didn't.
Yeah.
Yeah, and of course, my buddy, his father was like a firefighter, too. And so it was like, would have been real bad for him.
Mm-hmm.
He's caught out there with his dad. Firefighter. Anyways, I'm just rambling. Stream of consciousness. What?
I'm just trying to think of.
Jean's taking it easy this weekend, Shaw. She's got a lot of house projects to do, so.
Yeah, I don't have to work this weekend, which is.
Good for you.
For free.
The first time in a few weeks, so I'm super excited about that.
She's going to do laundry and cook and clean and all that crap.
Maybe some
all
shopping.
Stuff you've been putting off while you've been busy.
All the insane things that Jean does.
Yes.
What do you got going on?
A lot of basketball this weekend.
Like watching it? Or are you going to games? Or
no, I just watch it on television. It's the Big Ten Women's Tournament. Mm-hmm. Iowa plays tonight. They play Penn State, which beat Wisconsin last night. We watched that game. And all right, so, yeah, if they win tonight, they'll play tomorrow. If they win tomorrow, they'll play Sunday for the championship. So,
That's exciting.
We'll be watching a lot of that.
My wife's out of town.
Uh-oh.
Yes.
No. It's not like you get dangerous when she's gone.
Not more.
That's what I'm saying.
I'm pretty, well, it's, I get day drunk, then I go home and then I'm good.
Yeah, you're watching sports, you're playing games.
No, I'm sleeping.
Games.
I'm going, I'm, yeah. She's going to Iowa. Girls weekend.
Concert?
No, girls weekend. Apparently they're going to some hee-haw bar. So there's four of them, and one of them is into country music and stuff. And she's not, so the three out of the four, my wife and the other two, they like wine and breweries and stuff like that. And Ashley just likes good old American light beer. That's it. You know what I mean? She's just not going to deviate. And so all those trips to the winery, she'll go and she'll, you know, sort of, and just to, you know, but be there with the girls.
Where's my Busch Light?
But she wants to, she wants to go to the country bar and yeehaw it up. So my wife has been Googling yeehaw bars down there. There's plenty of them, by the way.
Yeah, oh, I'm sure you'll find a place. They'll find a place to go.
Yeah. Go and get
Rock Mornings. On air, online, on the app.
You said wood. Wood. Bless you.
Thank you.
Hey, Beavis. Rock Mornings, Brian and Gene. Bucks off last night. They're at the Lakers tonight. That's a 9 p.m. tip on ESPN. So you're going to have to stay up late to watch that one. West Coast swing.
West Coast.
Try to figure things out after that 35-point loss to the Warriors the other night. A.J. Storr got 19 points, grabbed 7 rebounds, led the Badgers to a 78-66 win over Rutgers in their final home game of the season last night. Wisconsin will seek its 20th win of the year when it travels to face number 3 Purdue in its regular season finale on Sunday.
This weekend, Shaw was just talking about all the basketball this weekend.
Yeah, the girls' basketball, of course, the Big Ten tournament going
Iowa
on this weekend.
Iowa playing tonight.
And then after the Badgers play Rutgers, the Big Ten tournament, of course, will happen before March Madness. Selection Sunday is next Sunday, by the way.
I did know that, yeah.
So brackets, brackets, brackets.
It's time.
Jake Paul, the YouTuber turned boxer, will face former heavyweight champ Mike Tyson.
I saw...
This dropped yesterday late in the morning, and I was like, is that real?
I saw the headline, and I didn't go into it any deeper than that, but that's a real thing. Is this a pay-per-view thing?
I don't exactly know how it works, because it's going to be on Netflix, but I'm guessing you're going to have to pay for it, right? You can't just be a Netflix subscriber and get it for free, right?
I don't... there has to be a limit.
I didn't look into it, because I don't... I mean, if it's free, I'll watch it. If it's pay-per-view, I'm not. I'll just get the highlights the next day. But yeah, Mike Tyson and Jake Paul in a boxing match, July 20th from AT&T Stadium in Dallas. It's billed as a heavyweight boxing mega event. Will be streamed live on Netflix. Tyson is 57, by the way. Last fought professionally in 2005, which was 19 years ago, FYI.
That's what I'm saying.
He was knocked out by a guy named Kevin McBride back then. So, yeah. They'll probably use bigger gloves, heavier gloves, right? As opposed to, you know, the traditional boxing gloves. And, yeah, I don't know.
It sounds like it's going to be live on Netflix.
If Jake Paul is smart, he'll lose to Tyson in the first one, come back for a rematch, beat him in the second one, and then do the rubber match, and then all bets are off, right? I mean, that's what this is. It's an attempt to make a butt ton of money. So lose to Tyson in the first one, go down, you know, make it exciting. Lose to Tyson, everybody gets hyped up. The Tyson thing comes back, people get hyped up. They want to see Tyson, right? He's the show. And then you have a best of three.
Tyson's 58. He's 27.
Yeah. And he's good. I mean,
I know.
People say he's a good boxer. Timberwolves All-Star center Carl Anthony Towns going to undergo surgery to repair a torn left meniscus. He is expected to be back by early in the Western Conference playoffs. And Ovi, Alexander the Great, scored his 840th career goal, added an assist as the visiting Capitals drilled the reeling Pittsburgh Penguins 6-0 last night. Ovechkin's 2 points pushed him past Hall of Famer defenseman Paul Coffey and into 15th on the NHL's career scoring list. The Russian superstar has 1,532 career points, only one shy of Hall of Fame forward Mark Recchi, in 14th place. So Ovi's going to pass him here. And this is funny. I didn't read more than the first paragraph and the headline because I just thought it was hilarious. After anti-doping officers from Spain's Commission for the Fight Against Doping in Sports showed up to perform random controls on riders of the amateur interclub Vinalopó in Spain on Saturday, only 52 of the 182 starters came through the finish line. So this is a bike race, bicycle race. Right. There's 182 riders.
And they'd say,
they found out that they were going to test for dope at the end, at the finish line. And out of the 182, only 52.
All right. 130 of them went, nah.
Nope.
Not today.
130 of them said, oh, I'm not peeing clean today. So I'm out of here. I saw the headline and I had to.
More than half.
Yeah, way more than half. Yeah. Shaw coming up in a few. Disturbed as well. Get in touch with us. Visit rockmornings.com.
Rock Mornings. Only on 95.7 The Rock.
Oh, you know who you are. You've been doing your daily action, putting lots of overtime. You need some time off satisfaction. Just think how tough it's been. You've been putting out all that labor. If you use your wit, you can get out quick and do yourself a favor. Friday in effect, and you're pretty beat, I bet. It's been one tough week, you've hit your peak, and you've earned your paycheck. But now this week is over, and it's a little fun you're seeking. Your grin is wide, and I know why. Look out, here come the weekend.
Know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
The weekend?
That weekend's gonna be a monster, y'all.
Oh! Kung Fu Panda 4.
That's right.
Theaters this weekend. Shaw, if you want to take a break from all of your basketball, you can go see Kung Fu Panda 4.
Well, I haven't seen the first three, so I'm afraid I wouldn't know what was going on.
It's a panda that does kung fu.
Okay.
And he's voiced by Jack Black. So I don't know if you really need to go back and watch all three of the originals, but...
You don't need to go back and watch them, but Kung Fu Panda 1, Shaw, is one of my favorite movies of all time. It's super hilarious. Oh.
Kung Fu Panda 4 in theaters... This weekend, on television today, over on Netflix, Damsel, a survivor thriller starring Millie Bobby Brown, 11 from Stranger Things.
Yep.
She plays a medieval damsel whose royal engagement is a sham because Prince Charming plans to offer her up as a sacrifice to an ancient fire-breathing dragon. I don't know if the dragon is Trogdor.
Probably not.
Burninating all the people?
Right, but that sounds like...
In their thatched roof cottages?
Definitely, she doesn't know what's going on, I can tell you that.
A Damsel on Netflix today. Over on Max, the streaming premiere of Wonka. In case you didn't catch it in theaters, you can watch that on Max. Tonight on HBO, Real Time with Bill Maher. This week's guests are Robert De Niro, Max Brooks, and Tara Palmieri. Over on Apple TV Plus today, it is the second season premiere of Eugene Levy's The Reluctant Traveler. All of the late night shows are in repeats except for Jimmy Fallon, who's got Naomi Campbell and Sue Bird. All the rest are in repeats tonight. As far as new music this weekend, starting today, you can pick up Judas Priest's new album, their 19th studio album. It's called Invincible Shield. Also, Kim Gordon, who is the guitarist and singer from Sonic Youth, has a new solo album called The Collective. So there you go. There's some stuff that's happening this weekend. TV, theaters, music. Basketball going to be on.
Sports for Shaw.
Got high school games, the girls' going, games and boys' games going
sportsing,
on.
Sportsing, lots of sportsing. Lots of sportsing. And Kung Fu Panda 4 in theaters. You want to go check it out. So what's happening in the real world?
Well, federal authorities have been investigating an apparent smuggling operation involving employees at a troubled Wisconsin prison. The probe has resulted in the suspension of nearly a dozen Waupun Correctional Institution employees. A spokesperson for Governor Tony Evers said that the Department of Corrections asked the U.S. Department of Justice and other federal authorities to launch the probe. They say they made the request after multiple sweeps of Waupun housing units revealed people in the prison were getting prohibited items such as cell phones and illegal drugs. An initial investigation by the Department of Corrections uncovered allegations that prison employees were involved, apparently getting paid to smuggle things in. The governor and Department of Corrections have asked federal authorities to investigate, given the potential involvement of state employees. According to the Department of Corrections, 11 prison employees have been placed on administrative leave.
Yikes.
The State of the Union was one of President Joe Biden's best chances to make the broadest possible case for his reelection. His speech came 2 days after Super Tuesday, when Donald Trump tightened his grip on the Republican presidential nomination, setting up a rematch between the two men in November. Biden used the opportunity to draw a sharp contrast that could rally Democrats to the polls as he tries to make the campaign a referendum on his predecessor rather than himself. He suffers from low poll numbers less than 8 months before the election, as well as facing doubts about his age. A coalition of conservation groups filed a last-minute federal lawsuit seeking to stop plans to build a high-voltage Cardinal Hickory Creek transmission line across a Mississippi River Wildlife Refuge. American Transmission Company and Dairyland Power Cooperative want to build this 102-mile, 345-kilovolt line linking Iowa's Dubuque County and Wisconsin's Dane County. A portion of that line would run through the Upper Mississippi River National Wildlife and Fish Refuge near Cassville, Wisconsin. The Federal Wildlife Refuge is a haven for fish, wildlife, and migratory birds that use it as their breeding grounds within the Mississippi River Flyway. Opponents have been trying to stop this project for years. Now, groups have filed an action in federal court in Madison seeking an injunction to block that refuge crossing. Once again this year, La Crosse area scouts got to hear some inspirational words from a veteran of the Green Bay Packers championship teams. Antonio Freeman played with the Pack when they won Super Bowl 31 back in the 90s. Freeman was the featured guest for the scouts' Golden Eagle dinner in La Crosse last night. The retired wide receiver enjoys hearing fans talk about the big plays he and the Packers made on the field.
You know, the people remember you for something positive, something good. There's a lot of guys that play this game that maybe didn't have the success that I might have enjoyed during my career, that maybe people don't have that same expression or reaction to when they see them. So it's always good to come back to Green Bay.
Freeman encourages young people to find ways of overcoming adversity and bounce back to try to be great again. The local scouts had their 21st annual dinner to raise money for scouting programs in the Gateway Area Council.
Three-way with Shaw. I got a text from Travis that was talking about my misdeeds as a Boy Scout, Cub Scout, Shaw.
Juvenile delinquent?
Yeah, well, a little bit. That had nothing to do with being a Cub Scout or a Boy Scout, though. No, that was just me in general. But,
yes.
But when I was a Cub Scout and eventually a Boy Scout, I faked
some badges.
Some of the badges. I just pretended I did them so my parents would sign off on them. Travis texted in on the Rock Line, said, an unlocked cabinet gunpowder and seeing what it mixes well with seeing what it mixes well with resulted in my friend's garage burning down when we were 8. It was awesome.
It was awesome.
Is Travis awesome. Like a mirror of me?
I don't.
Who is Travis? I got to meet this kid because every time I talk about some crazy wild stuff, Travis.
He's right there with you.
He's done the same kind of stuff. I said,
it's
almost.
It's not awesome.
Yes, it is.
No.
I said to Travis, I almost burned my house down trying to mix chemicals from under the sink. I told you about this one, too, right?
Yeah.
We had just gotten a sink remodel in my house. And we got a metal sink instead of the old cast iron or whatever. And, yeah, I was taking all the I was homesick one day from school, and I took all the chemicals, and I was mixing them and trying to light them on fire.
I'm glad my children didn't do things like that, Shaw.
And I burned
the... Did you have any burninators in your house?
I burned the curtains above the sink and tried to replace them with the curtains from the back bedroom, and...
Hoping that your mother wouldn't know the difference.
It wasn't my mother that I had to worry about. Dad does the beating. Mom just,
you know. But, like, she wouldn't notice the curtains were different?
I thought maybe.
It was worth a try.
Dude, I was, like, 7, okay? Right. That's what a 7-year-old's brain thinks. It's like, oh, I can't leave curtains. The burned ones here. They're in the kitchen. I'll take the ones from back here where no one goes. People go there, unfortunately.
Well, and it looks different.
No, they match. They're the same curtains. Oh. It just, they... Yeah. And, of course, the house reeked of burning curtains.
Sure.
So my dad comes home from work, and he's like, what stinks in here? What's burning? I'm like, I don't know.
I don't know. I have no idea.
2 minutes later, he's in that back bedroom, and then he's whooping my ass.
Yeah, of course.
Beating the brakes off me.
Yeah. What are you doing burning down the house?
Yeah. I think that was one. I think he got a stick on that one. I think I got a.
I had a.
Normally, it was just the belt or the hand, but like that one, he got a stick, Sean. I was.
Mm-hmm. I knew a kid who accidentally burned. I mean, that's why I'm saying, Travis, it's not funny. He accidentally started the barn on fire. And it.
Who?
A kid I went to high school
with
when he was young. And
playing with fire?
Playing with it.
Look, I'm not advocating. I'm just saying I have fond memories of
that's
it.
That's your
because I never did burn a house down.
But it was awful.
Yeah.
Awful.
Anyways, thank you, Travis. Get in touch with us. Visit rockmornings.com. We'll check in with Shaw again in just a few.
Rock Mornings, Monday to Friday, 6 to 9.
We're changing the clocks this weekend, right?
Yeah, we're springing forward.
Springing forward. Here's some other stuff you should do this weekend when you're springing those clocks forward. Obviously, your phone usually takes care of itself, but maybe the stove, maybe the microwave, maybe your
car,
radio next to the bed, whatever your alarm clock, might need to change that. Don't forget that alarm clock, by the way, if you have a traditional alarm. Like, you're going to have a problem on Monday if you don't change that time.
Yes.
Here's some other stuff you should do this weekend. since it is the time change, change the batteries in your smoke alarm.
This is the only time I remember that that's a thing I should do is when the time changes.
Or if they start beeping because they're dying.
Yeah, but otherwise, yeah. I mean, I never think about it.
Change the batteries in your smoke alarm. It's a good idea to change the batteries once a year. So doing it the same weekend as changing the clocks is a very nice and easy way to stay on top of that. As I mentioned the other day, also take a look at your filter and your furnace because this is the time of year when you start to turn the furnace off and open the windows. So maybe take a look at that thing. It's been running all winter. And especially if you've got animals or you burn candles or stuff like that, you're probably going to need to change that bad boy out. Here's another thing you should do. Restock your emergency kit. You have an emergency kit?
I have.
Like in your vehicle? My wife's got
first
one.
First aid kits.
My wife's got one in her car.
Yeah, we do too.
If you already have an emergency kit at home, go through it. Make sure nothing has expired. If you don't have one, then maybe put one together this weekend.
We had a...
So like what? Flashlight? Like in case the power goes out and you're stuck in your house?
Yeah, we have like a box that we had some stuff in it for tornado. If you have to go into the closet or whatever, as you know.
Well, yeah, when you're living on a farm in Black Earth. I need it, right?
Well, anywhere, right? Flashlight, charger, some water.
What about a bucket of ready-to-eat food?
No, I don't need it.
Wasn't that? Who was that? Rush Limbaugh selling that bucket of food? Oh, he had seed blankets, right?
Yeah, I don't remember, but I know.
Somebody had a big bucket of, and I think you can still get it. There's like a bucket of, and it's like noodles and stuff, right?
Biscuits.
Like a 5-gallon bucket of food. All right. Put a big 5-gallon bucket of food in your basement. Clean out your fridge, pantry, and medicine cabinet. Toss away anything that's expired or you're no longer using. Use up anything that's expiring soon. So that's another thing you should do this weekend with a time change. And last but not least, if you have a bed that has a mattress that can be flipped, it should be time to flip that mattress. So if it's usable on both sides.
Yeah.
Some mattresses should be flipped once or twice a year to avoid irregular wear. It's easy to remember if you do it the same weekend that you change your clock. So there you go. Some stuff that you should do this weekend with the time change. Obviously, remember to change those clocks as well. More from Shaw in a bit. Got some Stone Temple Pilots on the way. Get in touch with us. Visit rockmornings.com.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw.
Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. An emotional moment as a mother who was graduating got a very special message from her son who couldn't be there because he's active military.
Also want to take this time and share a very special message of congratulations to one graduate seated with us today, Jennifer Duggan. This special message is for you.
Hey, Mom. I know I'm not there for graduation, so I figured I'd make you a video and tell you I'm proud of you, congratulations, and I love you. Keep pushing. I'll see you soon.
Let's just say the tears were flowing. Jennifer Duggan, 50 years old, lives in Woodbury, Tennessee.
Went back to school.
Said, I was not expecting that at all, and I do not like to be the center of attention, but when Will popped up on the screen, I started to cry. It completely surprised me. Sergeant William Bailey, 28, can be heard saying, hey, Mom, dressed in his Tennessee Army National Guard uniform. I know I'm not there for graduation, so I figured I'd make you a video to tell you congratulations and I love you. Keep pushing. I'll see you soon. Duggan, by the way, is active military. Sergeant First Class Duggan, also of the Tennessee Army National Guard. She served in Iraq in the early 2009-2010 while raising her kids. Wasn't disappointed that her son was not there when she received a diploma for her master's degree in professional studies from Tennessee Tech. But obviously was very emotional about the video being played.
Yeah, of course.
She said, quote, we're military. We miss a lot of things, but he got to watch the ceremony live. And when we left, I called him crying and he said, I got you, didn't I? Yes, you did.
You sure did.
You got me. Very emotional video there.
Oh.
Good stuff. Also, this is good stuff. This is a cool story. In 1939, almost 100 years ago, a Chinese-American family in San Diego could not find a place to live because no one would rent to them. But a black couple named Emma and Gus Thompson stepped up to let them rent a place and eventually buy it. And now, 85 years later, the family, the Chinese-American family, has done very well for themselves. Obviously, not the original couple, but the entire family, many, many years later here, have done very well for themselves over the last 85 years. And now the original owner's sons are paying it forward by selling the house and donating $5 million to create scholarships for black college students.
Look at that full circle.
Right? A little bit of love and kindness shown by another couple that probably dealt with a lot of discrimination and racism and hatred.
Helping out someone and
then years later they're able to pay it back and pay it forward as well. Pretty cool. Rain and clouds and just kind of meh today in the area.
More rain south of I-90, a little bit more north clouds, but not wet, I guess.
Yeah, but going to clear up this weekend and be really nice on Sunday and even better on Monday with hopefully high temps near 70.
Rock Mornings on 95.7 The Rock.
It is Be Nasty Day, Shaw. Are you nasty?
Not right now.
Miss Jackson, if you're nasty.
If you're nasty.
Also, Retro Video Game Day. Mm. Go home, play Galaga. Do you have a favorite retro video game, Shaw?
I was an Asteroids guy.
Didn't like that one?
Too basic.
Couldn't do it?
I get why Shaw likes it. He's older. It was probably the first video game ever created, other than Pong.
Pretty much.
Like Pong and then Asteroids. I didn't like Asteroids. I was a Galaga guy. I enjoyed Miss Pac-Man over Pac-Man.
Me too.
With Miss Pac-Man, you got the boards changed.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Obviously, Donkey Kong was big when I was a kid. What's the one with the worm? Centipede? Centipede was big.
Yeah.
All the mushrooms.
Yep.
There was another one. Can't remember what the hell it was called. I think it started with a V, but like you had it was like a triangle like thing, and it was like when you go into warp speed, like in the movies and stuff, and there's like a tunnel.
Yeah.
So it's like a tunnel, and you're like, your character is this little triangle kind of looking guy, and he shoots bullets or whatever down the chute at enemies that are coming towards you, and you got to move around the outer. I can't remember the name of that thing, but I love that game too. I just can't remember the name of it. But it's also National Women's Day today. Do you know that?
I knew it was Women's History Month.
Okay.
I didn't know it was today.
In a new poll, Gene, this includes you because you're a woman, right?
This morning I checked.
Okay.
It was confirmed, yes.
52% of young women between the ages of 19 and 35 said that taking showers is the only me time they get in any given day. To process their stressors, emotions, and the ups and downs of daily life.
Sometimes she locks herself in the bathroom for some me time.
Mm-hmm.
52%. So over half of women aged 19 to 35 say the only time they get any me time. Really?
Well, if they have small children at home, that could very well be. Mm-hmm.
79% of women say they're in need of more me time right now. The women said they get bogged down by finances, work, and family stuff, and the alone time in the shower allows them to, quote, let their random thoughts roam, reflect on the day, and think about memories.
Your wife's having a nice getaway with girlfriends, right? A girlfriend weekend?
I don't know if it's nice, but she's going away.
Yeah.
We'll see what happens.
Getting together with some gal pals.
We'll see what happens.
A nice refresher, yeah.
Yeah.
It'll be good for the two of us to be apart.
And she's having fun with some friends.
We'll see about that. A guy can't stand in the shower and have some me time, Shaw?
Sure,
of course you can.
You can,
but that's not what this survey was about.
Like, you're special because you stand in the shower in the dark and think about your mistakes?
I think it's because it's Women's Day, as you mentioned, right?
So?
But these are facts.
When is Men's Day? Right. It's every other day of the year.
Right.
Shaw, how do you make a woman orgasm faster?
I don't know, Brian.
Who cares?
On this day, too, huh?
I love that joke. Me time, Shaw.
Gotta have it.
Yeah. I usually just stand in the shower with the lights on. I told you this in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
Just right there underneath the lava hot water and let it burn, baby. Hope that I go back to sleep and don't wake up. Ever. Is that me time? Yeah, you gotta have a lock on that bathroom door, too.
Sounds like a problem.
Well, especially since I got to stand in my shower, so if I fall down, it's going to be a problem. Big problem. Big pool of fat lard laying on the floor of my shower. Can't get up. I'm getting scalded by my lava hot water. I told you I had the guy come over because like when he installed the new tankless water heater and did a fantastic job, the water wasn't as hot as our old water heater was. And so I had him come over, and I was like, can you turn it up a little bit? And he's like, are you sure? And I was like, oh, yeah. Now it is scalding
hot.
So
you like your house ice cold and your shower lava hot.
Hell yeah. Not all the time. But I'm like that with the hot tub, too. I keep the hot tub at 104. I'd go higher if I could, but it's, you know, it maxes out at 104, 105, somewhere around there.
I take a hot shower more hot than my husband.
I'm all
sure.
about extremes, Shaw.
Apparently. I mean, not lava, I mean? Probably.
Like,
lava
I'm not going to drink just a beer and be satisfied. Like, I'm going to get...
You want 9 of them?
Yes.
How much of that pizza are you going to eat?
All of it. I'm going to cook the entire package of bacon.
Yes, you are.
And eat some of it. Maybe most of it. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
That's just who I am.
Don't do anything halfway.
Well, if I'm going to start binging an episode of something that I get into, I'm going to watch the whole damn thing in like 2 days' time, Shaw. I'm not going to mess around here.
You're not going to set a timer to tell you when to stop cleaning your bathroom Dude, or so stop weird. Watching a movie?
Shit, that can't be real. That cannot be real.
It is real. I blew my mind, but it was real.
You can't be that too. You can't be that scheduled. You can't. You Apparently have to finish the project.
I listened and watched part of it happen. It was there was timers and things.
Tempest, Mark just why did I think
Oh,
V?
I remember that.
Remember Tempest? It was like a blue yes. it was like a blue yes. funnel and you're like the yellow guy and it was like a triangle kind of mm-hmm. looking thing or like a
I do remember.
And you go all around the side and in different shapes and stuff like that and then you'd warp down it into the next level and to watch out for yes. like the enemies and so yeah. Thank you Mark. My buddy Mark texted me. Three-way now with Shaw in the newsroom after I've just kind of rambled. Sorry. I'm just, you know, a lot of stream of consciousness going on.
It's Friday.
It's Friday, yeah. More child neglect charges have been filed against the mother of 3-year-old Elijah View, who was reported missing 2 weeks ago. A judge has also rejected a bond reduction for Katrina Bauer, who's being held in jail on a $15,000 cash bond. The boy was last seen in February at a home in Two Rivers. Bauer's attorney says her client is worried sick, not knowing where her son is. A former high school teacher from Strum has been sentenced for inappropriately touching a former student. 33-year-old Nicholas Bergeron was sentenced to a year in jail and 5 years probation yesterday for inappropriately touching a former student while he was a teacher at Osseo Fairchild High School. A jury had found Bergeron guilty of second-degree sexual assault of a child back in October. A southeast Minnesota woman now has an attorney to represent her following a fatal crash with an Amish buggy. Samantha Peterson of Fillmore County is facing a number of charges in connection with the September crash, which killed 2 Amish girls, ages 7 and 11. According to the criminal complaint, after the crash, Samantha tried to convince deputies her twin sister, Sarah, was driving when it collided with the buggy. Police said the sisters had a history of trying to deceive authorities by pretending to be one another. Samantha reportedly did not want to take blame for the crash because she was high on meth at the time. Her sister is facing separate charges. She does not yet have an attorney to represent her. The World Championship Cheese Contest wrapped up yesterday in Madison. The contest featured more than 3,300 entries from more than 140 countries. This year's winner was Mountain Dairy Fritzenhaus from Switzerland.
I like cheese.
First runner-up was Dutch Cheesemakers from the Netherlands. Second runner-up was The Farm at Doe Run in Pennsylvania. Wisconsin Cheesemakers took top honors in 39 of the 142 categories.
Oh my God.
What was that? What was that? Is that cheese? Have you eaten cheese?
How much cheese have you eaten today?
How much cheese is too much cheese?
Any amount of cheese before a date is too much cheese.
I had a lot of cheese. I had a block of cheese.
Okay, just a block of cheese
I was
today.
Very nervous. I started eating cheese, man. All right. Does that calm you down?
Just don't breathe in her direction, okay? Whatever you do.
Careful how much cheese
How much cheese you eat, yes.
Yo, man.
And social media star turned boxer Jake Paul will fight former heavyweight champ Mike Tyson at AT&T Stadium coming up in July, a fight to be broadcast on Netflix. The streaming platform will provide live coverage of the bout between the 27-year-old Paul and 57-year-old Tyson, who hasn't fought since 2020. Paul and Tyson will be the main event of the first combat sports show for Netflix, part of its recent forays into live sports production. Still uncertain whether this bout will be staged as an actual pro fight or an exhibition, particularly given the age of Tyson, who will be 58 by July. The specifics must still be approved by the Texas Department of Licensing.
My style is impetuous. My defense is impregnable, and I'm just ferocious. I want your heart. I want to eat his children. Praise be to Allah.
There was nothing better for that 10 years or whatever it was, Shaw, when he
was reigning champion.
It was just a scene, man. Uh-huh. And I didn't give a rat's ass about boxing. I mean, you know about Hagler and Hearns and all that, you know, and Ali and every. But like, man, Tyson would just destroy people.
He would hit them so hard with an uppercut, it would take their feet off of the ring.
It would
lift them into the air with a punch.
If there was ever such a thing as must-watch TV, Tyson fights, in my opinion, were must-watch. You had to. You couldn't. You were riveted by it. I mean, he was just this.
You've never seen anything like
him. Maniac, and he just destroyed people. And they're, you know, at first, you know, these tomato cans they put in there, right? Because you got to work your way up to get into the, you know, into the upper echelon. But like, man, it was just nuts. And that was what was so wild when he lost to Buster Douglas. Because you're like, what? You're like, huh?
This guy, right?
This guy, this doughy loser that no one's ever heard of. Oh, it was great. Tyson fights.
I don't know, man. I might get fade into Bolivian. You know what I mean?
Bolivian.
Birds. Isn't he a pigeon guy?
Yes. Like, oh, yeah. He had a little.
Racist pigeon.
I think he had a show, right?
Yeah, he did.
Like a Netflix show or something, or like a. Yeah. Thank you, by the way, to Kevin, who also texted in that it was Tempest, the name of the video game I was looking for. Doc texted in. He thought it was something called Omega Race. I don't remember that.
I don't either.
But no, it was Tempest, Shaw. Do you remember that game, Tempest? Yeah?
I do.
All right.
A long time ago.
Yeah. Oh, I haven't played in years, but I remember vividly it was on a console at the campground that I went to when I was a kid, and
yeah.
I played the hell out of it.
I didn't remember until I looked at the pictures, and now I do.
Also got an email from Doug, who's celebrating his birthday today, wants to hear some Kid Rock.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw.
That is some Kid Rock for my buddy Doug, who celebrates his birthday today. Boy, we've made some memories. I was just reminiscing a little bit about some of the... We used to do this thing
memories.
Called the dive bar tour, and it was a group of us, and we wanted to... Because there's so many bars here in La Crosse, and we only go to a few of them...
And surrounding areas.
We wanted to start going to some of the bars that we didn't normally go to. That was kind of the... It wasn't necessarily that we wanted to go to dumps, you know what I mean? It was just more about going to bars that we didn't normally, you know, go to or patronize. And so we started going to these places.
Seeing what's out there, checking out different places.
And we went to one place one time, and, you know, Doug loves Kid Rock, and so he starts playing it on the jukebox, and it's, you know, middle of the afternoon, and he's getting on one, and there's some old-timer at the bar, and we had, I don't know, you know, this is a Thursday afternoon at like 4 o'clock, so the bar is jam-packed with people. It's us, right? It's our group of 30 people. So the bartender's like having a day, right?
Very happy.
She's very happy, making a ton of money. We're tipping well. Doug's playing the Kid Rock. And this dude sitting at the bar is just not having it. He's so pissed off, and he's letting her know.
I don't like the song.
Yeah, I don't. Yeah, turn that down. And, like, of course, Doug's like, can you turn it up a little bit? And she, of course, yeah, hell yeah. She turns right up, and he's singing along to the words, and it's a very profane Kid Rock song. I think it was Mother Effer Like Me. You never met another mother. And so, like, Doug's singing along to this thing at the top of his lungs, and this old dude's like, just
not having
I'm going to take my business elsewhere. This is ridiculous. I can't dance this stupid music. Ah. Oh, my God. We were all dying laughing. So funny. It wasn't even like a regular either. Like, you get it if it's a regular. Some guy that's there every day and right.
This is my bar, and how dare you come in here and disrupt things. But
no, he was just some old guy that was cranky and upset. And
really did not like Kid Rock.
That's one of the only stories I can tell on the radio of the times that we had at the dive bar tour.
The rest are.
Very adult. Yeah. Oofta. Hey, the Bucks were off last night. They play at the Lakers tonight. 9 p.m. tip-off on ESPN for that game. Badgers got a win over Rutgers last night. They play Purdue on Sunday in the regular season finale. T-Wolves All-Star Center Karl Anthony Towns, KAT, going to undergo surgery to repair a torn left meniscus. He is expected to be back by the early portion of the Western Conference playoffs. And Patrick Mahomes, Super Bowl-winning quarterback.
Yep.
Very popular in all the commercials, right? State Farm commercials all over the place. He visited the Oak Park Mall in Kansas City last week. Just showed up at the mall. People doing their shopping, walking around in the food court. And there's Patrick Mahomes. Got security. Got a police officer with him. Bodyguard. People grabbing their phones, running up to him. Apparently went into the American Outfitters. A Chiefs fan wrote on Facebook. They posted a photo of the three-time Super Bowl champ surrounded by shoppers. Got lucky, big security couldn't get closer. Another fan of the quarterback on Facebook said, I finally had a chance to see Patrick Mahomes at the Oak Park Mall this afternoon and left my phone in my boyfriend's car. Shame on me.
Yeah, he was out. He's also married and got kids.
Man of the people, right? He's got to go get diapers. Unfortunately, it wasn't Patrick Mahomes.
It was a lookalike?
Yeah, it was a prank. All these people are freaking out that Patrick Mahomes at the Oak Park Mall in Kansas City, and it wasn't him. And when you get a good look at him, when you get an up close and personal,
you can
totally tell it's not
but
him.
But he's got kind of the
he's got kind of the he's got yeah he went in deep. Like, kudos. It wasn't like some guy that just looks like Patrick Mahomes that people mistook. This was an intended prank, right? They went there looking to get people riled up. Had a guy all decked out like a bodyguard.
Yeah.
The vest and everything. Had the sunglasses on, the Patrick Mahomes sunglasses. Had the poofy hair that he has. Kind of curly up there on top. Had a Chiefs sweatshirt. Oh, yeah. The lookalike guy is known on social media as Z. He's on TikTok. At zbo.nohomes.
Okay.
And
does he do this kind of thing a lot?
Zbo4lean on Instagram. Calls himself the Walmart Patrick Mahomes.
There you go.
He's the everyday essential Patrick Mahomes. The fake Pat teamed up with a prankster named Victor Galvin, a.k.a. Vic in the Game, on Instagram and YouTube. And also a content creator with 53,000 followers on Gram. The assignment was to walk through malls in Omaha and Kansas City and see what kind of chaos would ensue. And
so he looks like him, and he's kind of got, that's what he does, is pretend to be him.
And people were freaking out thinking that it was actually Patrick Mahomes.
They took it to another level with security and all that.
It's good on them. Pretty funny. So be careful if you're out there thinking you're running into Patrick Mahomes. May not be him. Get a closer look. Sports. Get in touch with us. Visit rockmornings.com. We'll get to some Green Day in just a couple of minutes.
Rock Mornings on your rock station.
Daylight Saving Time presents 1 hour into the future. Congratulations. By utilizing spring forward technology, you have successfully traveled 1 hour into the future. Here you'll find life is much different. Everyone has a flying car, a lunar vacation home, a sexy robot girlfriend, and the planet is controlled by a race of evil machines that live off human body heat for electrochemical energy. Enjoy your 6 month stay here in Future World. And remember, returning to the past with sports scores, lottery numbers, and stock tips is strictly prohibited.
I need your clothes, your boots, and your motorcycle.
And an hour of your time.
Wow! We're changing the time, Shaw.
Yep.
We're springing forward.
We are.
So it'll be darker in the morning for a while until we even out later in the summer. It'll be lighter at night.
Mm-hmm. Can it get darker when you wake up at 1 a.m.?
I think it's
dark is dark.
It's hardest on little kids, too. That schedule gets rough, and they get very tired and lots of tantrums, Shaw. You remember that?
When
it was like, it would take a while, like a month.
To adjust, yeah.
You know how you avoid that? Huh. Don't have kids.
Mm-hmm.
Get them outside this
weekend. I think it's tougher on dogs. You ever have a dog with a specific feeding time? Like 5 p.m.?
And they're standing in the kitchen.
And then you're springing forward and they're
4
like...
4 p.m.? They're like, where's my food?
They're like, dude, what's going on, bro? Like, looking at you, staring at you, drooling. Like, come on, man. They're right over there. The bowls are over there. They're over there. I can see them.
The time.
They're right over there. I know the food's... I know where the food is, too. I just don't have the... I don't have the thumbs. I can't do it. You got to do it for me, bro. Come on, man. What do you mean time change? What's time change? I don't know about this time change. It's feeding time. That's what time it is. Right now. Yesterday you fed me at the same time. What's going on? Dude. And two of them. Both of them. Looking at you. Maggie's the worst. The boxer. Oh, my God. She looks at you like you just beat her mother to death. You know what I mean? She's like, aah. You know, and I'm like, look, I'm not punishing you.
You got an hour.
You got an hour to wait.
60 minutes. You'll be all right.
Change the batteries in your smoke alarms.
Yeah, good reminder.
Right? Earlier we talked about this. Flip your mattress, maybe. Check your filter in your furnace, Shaw.
Mm-hmm.
Those kind of things. The one thing I always hated was the TV schedule on Sunday. You know what I mean? Because, like, the time change goes into effect, but the TV times are all scheduled weeks in advance, right? So you're looking at it, you know, on the TV guide or... when you're channel surfing, like, is that actually noon or is that 11 tomorrow? I don't want to miss out.
What about the Oscars tomorrow on Sunday night, Shaw? Do you have any information?
Well, they start early. They'll start at 6 o'clock our time. That has nothing to do with daylight saving time. That's simply the fact that they're trying to get this thing done sooner in the evening because it goes on for so long. So, and Jimmy Kimmel will be the host, of course.
Yeah. It's on ABC, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Three-way with Shaw. What else is happening?
Scientists calculate that for the ninth straight month, the Earth has obliterated global heat records. The European Union's climate agency says February and the winter as a whole, as well as the world's oceans, all set new high temperature marks. Sea surface temperatures weren't just the hottest for February, but are eclipsing any month on record, soaring past August 2023's mark and still rising. Scientists say it's clearly long-term human-caused warming from the burning of coal, oil, and gas, along with a boost from the natural El Niño's warming of the Central Pacific that alters weather worldwide. Remember years ago when La Crosse police shot a bear in Myrick Park after it crawled up a tree?
Yeah.
People mourned the loss of the bear and thought police should have let it be
or
relocated it.
Well, trank it and take it somewhere else.
Right. Well, meanwhile, in Florida, so long as they don't eat them, stuff them, or turn them into hats for the British Royal Guard, Florida residents will be allowed to kill any black bears that they believe are threatening them on their property with no consequences. That under a bill sent to Governor Ron DeSantis yesterday. The once threatened Florida black bear population has increasingly wandered into neighborhoods and private property. The legislation is similar to the Stand Your Ground law that allows people to use deadly force against other people that are threatening them. Supporters say Floridians have the right to defend themselves, their families, pets, and property against bears coming around looking for food, but opponents fear people will become trigger happy and not take other precautions against bears.
Do they gotta gut it and properly?
Not like the musher.
No, they don't have the
but they're not allowed to keep. They were not allowed to keep the meat or the pelt, so you can't just kill one because you want to make a bear rug. You know,
the bears can smell the menstruation.
So they're having a lot of interactions between people and bears.
That's
and
what they're saying. Yeah, it's
close
the problem's
encounters.
Getting worse. Yeah. The studio of Dragon Ball creator Akira Toriyama says he has now died at the age of 68. The series started in 1984 and has become an international million seller, turned into hugely popular anime series, video games, and films. Dragon Ball is the story of Son Goku and his adventure in search of magical balls to make his wishes come true. A rare calf born with two faces. It's continuing to flourish after being born last month at a farm in Louisiana.
Do both faces work?
Yes. The calf is named Dewface and is still striving. Dewface has four eyes, two mouths, two noses, and two ears. Everything from the ears back appears to be normal. The owners said that the chance of this type of birth is about 1 in 400 million. They say the calf does not appear to be suffering in any way. The owners say she's beaten many odds, but only time will tell. Her face.
Yeah, plural. We got is it one or two?
Right. Four legs, but also four eyes.
Where are the faces? They go this way?
Yes.
How does it work? Are they on the sides?
That sides.
So it's like a V?
Kinda.
Yeah.
I'm trying.
Let me see it. Show it to me.
I'm trying.
Come on, woman.
Oh boy. Yeah? It does look bad.
It looks like an art project gone bad. Oh, man.
It's got two, and everything works. Like,
yeah,
you can
everything
breathe
works.
And eyes blink.
Yeah,
and
yeah, it can eat out of either mouth, see out of either set of eyes.
It's like Andy Garcia.
Oh, with the eating of the twin? Is this what you're talking about?
Remember he's got the scar on his shoulder because his twin was grown out of his arm or something? Creepy. Thank you, Shaw.
Mm-hmm.
Rockmornings.com. You can visit us there. You can listen to our daily podcast in case you missed something from the program. Daily podcast updated daily sometime between 9 and 10 a.m.
Yep.
Bunch of our old interviews in there, including our interview with Mr. Skin from earlier this week, his Anatomy Awards, speaking of the Academy Awards. Talk to him about that.
Always the week of.
Let's see. What do we got? Got a whole bunch of text messages. We're talking about my dad's gunpowder earlier. Jim texted in and said, we made our own M80s, put them in mailboxes. We got our butts beat.
Oh, man.
I never...
Super illegal.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Super illegal.
When I was like 10 years old, we went to Disney World in Florida, and we drove down towing our camper, and we stopped at South of the Border, which is a very famous fireworks place in between North Carolina and South Carolina, I believe. And they have grocery carts that you fill up with fireworks, you know? And so we had a bunch of M80s left over from that, so I would take a few of those. I didn't try to make any M80s, but Cordell texted and said, I remember playing with fire, lighting a fire in the garage, the garbage can at my parents' house, and I also remember nearly blowing up their old wood stove.
Yeah.
Yeah. Donnie wants to hear some Rocket Queen. Let's get this Emmer effin' Friday turnt up.
He's ready.
Talking about retro video games. Chris, who is in Chicago, said Sinistar was a badass video game. I'd never heard of it. I got to look it up. And our buddy James in Altoona said, can we start the best day of the week with some good old Static X? Yes, we can.
More of your Rock Mornings coming up in just a bit.
Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. That is Papa Roach. Got some Static X before that for James in Altoona. A good weekend, James. Also, it's International Women's Day. We talked about this earlier in the me time in the shower for women age 19 to 35. Rockfest just posted a bunch of pictures celebrating the fierce women of our Rockfest family. This hashtag International Women's Day. Tag the ladies in your life who embody the spirit of rock. And look who made the photo section. This guy with my wife on my shoulders.
Well, yeah.
I think that was from last year. I don't remember. It looks like a last year picture of me. There's our buddy Jesse standing right next to me. My buddy Dave DeVille there in the back, looking stoned as hell. But yeah, Rockfest, before you know it, it'll be here, man. It's already March. March is half over next week. Then it's April, May, June, then bam, Rockfest is here.
I agree.
Check out Rockfest new posts on their Facebook page about International Women's Day.
And getting your tickets.
And get your tickets at rock-fest.com. Especially camping. That is running out.
Or non-existent, almost.
Well, I think there's still campsites, but as we found out last year, that could come to an end at some point. So, Rockfest right around the corner. Very excited about that. We've got, of course, so many great bands like Shinedown and Chevelle and Seven Dust. I'm really looking forward to The Who and Two Live Crew. I've never seen either of those bands.
Well, it's fun when you get an opportunity to see bands you've never seen before.
And The Who is, yeah, I mean, this Mongolian death metal thing looks cool as hell. So,
how interesting to watch.
Yeah. All the details and tickets and camping, everything you need to know online at rock-fest.com. We're going to talk racing with Doc. We're going to get to Shaw for one more three-way, plus bad news, happy music. Lots going on here.
Rock Mornings. On air. Online. On the app.
James Vanderbeek is 47. He's the Dawson from the Dawson's Creek.
Holy shit, you're the Dawson.
James, actually. James Vanderbeek.
What's up with Pacey stealing Joey away from you? If I was you, I would have drowned his ass in the creek and shit.
You actually watched that show?
Yeah, for Joey, man. She is too fun.
Gary Newman. One hit wonder. 66 years old. Remember his one hit?
I will when I hear it. Here in my car, I have to sing this song. Yep. I can lock on my doors.
It's the only way to live in cars. Fear Factory. Did a nice little cover of that.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe we'll play it. Gary Newman, 66. Mickey Dolenz of the Monkees. Here we come. 79. I think he's the last one, right?
I was just going to say, he's the last one alive, isn't he?
He was the drummer and sang most of the hits, even though Davy Jones was the front man.
Front man. Hey, we're the Monkees.
People say we monkey around. Mickey Dolenz, 79. Susan Clark is 81. She was the mom on Webster. Emmanuel Lewis.
Yeah, didn't watch.
Also was the stripper in Porky's. Cherry Forever, no? That penis had a mole in it.
It did.
Yeah, she's 81. And the skipper on Gilligan's Island, Alan Hale, born on this day in 1921. Died in 1990. The SS Minnow. Did not pass go, did not collect 200.
One of my favorite
theme songs
to sing. Yeah. Usually
embarrassing the children?
When I'm floating down a river in a tube or in some sort of a canoe and my family is around me and so are other people.
And there's alcohol involved?
And then I can break into that really loudly and then they try very hard to get their tubes as far away from me as they can.
We went on the Kickapoo several years ago with some friends of ours and their kids. And, of course, I don't have kids, so I got rip-roaring drunk and made a complete ass of myself. But at one point, we were trading. They had brought, so you know you get the King's Hawaiian rolls?
Yes.
You know? The, mm-hmm. And they had cut them off in half and made, like, ham and cheese sandwiches.
Yes.
And we had a big pile of those. And, of course, when you're drunk, you're just hammering those damn things because they're little and they're delicious. Well, we ran into some people that had Jell-O shots and wanted to trade us Jell-O shots for our King's Hawaiian sandwiches. So even though they weren't mine, I was trading these sandwiches.
The
these
food
for
that
Jell-O
was for the children?
Oh, yeah.
Nice. That was great.
Yeah.
I bet they appreciated that.
That's me as a parent. That's Funkel. That's Funkel Brian right over
those,
there.
Those are for the kids to
those
eat.
Those are memories that'll last a lifetime. Take those with you, kids. 1948, 76 years ago, the Supreme Court ruled that it was unconstitutional to teach religion in public schools. The landmark case of McCollum versus the Board of Education. 1973. It's a bummer that Shaw's not with us right now, but it's his favorite Grateful Dead song.
Looking high.
51 years ago today, 1973, Ron Pigpen McKernan of the Grateful Dead died from stomach hemorrhage.
That sounds painful.
Yeah, very. 39 years ago today, 1985, the movie Mask in theaters starring Eric Stoltz, Cher, and your guy, Sam Elliott, on a Harley.
These things are good. Ice cream and cake, a ride on a Harley, seeing monkeys in the trees, the rain on my tongue, and the sun shining on my face.
Aw, Rocky Dennis.
Ugh, that movie.
Had the pins, right, in the map?
The pins in the map.
Yeah. 1991, the movie New Jack City in theaters starring Wesley Snipes.
Whatever happened to Am I My Brother's Keeper, huh?
I'm going to have to watch that one today. It's a good movie. 1993. 31 years ago today, it officially debuted as a series on MTV. There were two shorts that aired from September to November in 92, but the following year, 1993, is when it officially became a television show.
Okay.
Beavis and Butthead. Which side are you on, Beavis or Butthead?
Probably Beavis.
I like Beavis. I am the great portfolio. I need to be for my bungalow. 1994, two albums came out on the very same day.
Yes, what were they?
Influential rock albums. Massive, like, huge rock. I hate to say them classic, but this was 30 years ago. Soundgarden dropped their fourth album, Super Unknown.
Oof, full of good songs.
Oh, just all hits.
Yeah.
And Nine Inch Nails releasing their second album, The Downward Spiral. Hurt. Closer, a whole bunch of others. Both of them out on the same day. 96, the movie The Birdcage in theaters starring Robin Williams, may he rest in peace, and Nathan Lane.
Oh, oh my God, are you crazy? What are you doing?
Stellar performance. 2005, 19 years ago today, Zach Wilde and the Black Label Society released their sixth album, Mafia, including In This River, the song about Dimebag.
Mm-hmm.
It's a great tune. 2011, Mike Starr, bass player for Alice in Chains, died at the age of 44. There's a car accident, right? Pretty sure that's what got him. And just 4 years ago today, 2020, the legendary actor Max von Sydow died at the age of 90.
The power of Christ compels you.
Oh.
The power of Christ compels you.
Yeah, that Max von Sydow. There you go. Some birthdays, pop culture stuff. Scott Robert Shaw coming up in a few. For one more three-way, and of course, Bad News Happy Music a bit later on. Doc's going to join us to talk racing as well.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw.
Scott Robert Shaw. No?
Explosions.
Not a thing, no?
Mm-hmm. I'm feeling it today.
On a Friday?
Yeah.
I'm feeling it.
Congrats.
TGIF, Sean.
I'm
feeling it.
I am.
Write that one down. Devin texted in on the Rock Line, wants to hear some Iron Maiden. Carol.
Hi, I'm Carol. I got to go home and watch my stories.
Office Christmas party. Wants to listen to System of a Down.
Okay.
Also requests for some Guns N' Roses. Try to get to that. Thank you very much, everybody, reaching out, getting in touch with us. Visit rockmornings.com if you want to get in touch with us. Our, by the way, our daily podcast is on there as well, Shaw. So that's been getting, was it 3 weeks now? Something like that. 3 or 4 weeks, daily podcast available shortly after the show's over. So if you missed anything or if you didn't get a chance to listen and you want to go give it a check, rockmornings.com, daily podcast available.
That's nice, Shaw.
Yeah, I'll check that out.
So just remember that. Things you say.
Yeah, live in infamy.
Could be.
Can and will be used against you.
Most certainly will be.
In a court of law.
Absolutely.
All right, Shaw?
Got it.
What's going on?
President Joe Biden delivered a defiant argument for a second term in his State of the Union speech last night, criticizing his opponent, Donald Trump, for espousing resentment, revenge, and retribution, and for jeopardizing freedom at home and abroad. Biden repeatedly delivered broadsides at my predecessor without ever mentioning Trump by name. The scrappy tone from Biden was a sharp break from his often humdrum daily appearances and was designed to erase any doubts about whether the 81-year-old is still up to the job.
They may take our land, but they'll never take our freedom!
Meanwhile, a heckler at last night's State of the Union address is the congressman representing Western Wisconsin. Congressman Derek Van Orden interrupted President Joe Biden's speech to the country last night.
You mean the state representative?
No, he's not a state representative.
Boy, he got so mad at me.
Biden was criticizing Donald Trump for his handling of the coronavirus pandemic when Van Orden shouted lies. Van Orden later said he thought it was shameful that Biden disparaged the former president. A lacrosse man suspected in a Northside shooting is asking for a speedy trial and a court-appointed attorney. Linnell Carter was arrested in January and charged with attempted murder for allegedly shooting a man in the leg during a dispute. During a court hearing yesterday, Carter suggested he'd been threatened by the victim in the incident. Carter's bail remains at $500,000. He has another court hearing set for March 20th. Alone, Cole Brower braved three oceans and the elements as she navigated her sailboat for months. When she and her 40-foot sailboat arrived yesterday in Spain, the 29-year-old became the first American woman to race nonstop around the world by herself, traveling some 30,000 miles.
God damn.
Brower, all 5'2" and 100 pounds of her, is one of more than a dozen sailors competing in the Global Solo Challenge. She was the youngest and the only woman in the group that set sail in October from Spain. The race took Brower south along the west coast of Africa, around the Cape of Good Hope, then eastward toward Australia. Wow. She had was able to.
I've been everywhere, man. Yeah, I crossed the desert and sand, man. I've been everywhere.
The race took her 130 days to complete.
Maybe that's what the bathtub guy was trying to do.
That is so
impressive. Before they destroyed his bathtub. That's awesome.
I'm a sailor around the world by myself.
Right. Be hard enough with a full crew.
Yeah. You really got to be a different kind of human being.
Agreed. Completely agree.
I don't know if I could ever hang out with people like that, that are like super type A. You know what I mean? Like the rock climbing dudes.
Yeah.
You know, the bear handers with no ropes and all that crap. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I could ever like have a conversation with someone. I'd be like, what? You don't want to just take a nap and play some video games?
Well, and completely alone. Willing to be like alone and
that I don't have a problem with that. I'm okay.
In the middle of the ocean?
No way. No,
oh, that part. No.
130 days?
No.
Sharks. How many sharks out there, Shaw?
Mm-mm.
Bad news, happy music coming up. How are we looking?
Well, a couple of women tried to use the Weekend at Bernie's trick to steal from a dead man.
Doesn't anybody recognize that he's dead? All right. We'll get to that in a bit, but first we got to get to Doc. He's going to join us in a couple of minutes to talk racing.
Rock Mornings, only on 95.7 The Rock.
Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. That is the Struts, too good at raising hell. Every Friday morning, we're joined by the Mid-Pack legend, Mr. Technicality, Car 54, Billy Doc Niles, a.k.a. Captain Retirement, a.k.a. hashtag Mr. Fister, a.k.a. hashtag this guy.
Happy
Gillespie.
In a voicemail, no less. Happy 4th of July. Hashtag this guy.
I'm kind of anal.
Whoa, he's kind of anal. Hashtag this guy.
He's got it locked on the rock. He's listening to the doc.
Hashtag this guy.
You're getting a thrill by listening to Bill.
Oh, yes, I am. Hashtag this guy.
Gonna have to come from the back.
Gonna have to come from the back. Hashtag this guy.
Whoa, what am I touching here?
Whoa, what are you touching there, doc?
You know, I'm touching my forehead right now wondering why you just couldn't delete the voicemail.
Never.
Never. I'm sorry.
When I first moved here,
ammunition.
When I first moved here in 2003, Ken Cooper, our wonderful production director here at Midwest Family, said save everything and label it appropriately so you can find it, because you never know when you're going to want to have to go back and find something again. And that's what I've been doing for 20 years in this building.
Damn you, Cooper.
And now the stupid engineers want to delete a bunch of crap so they can transfer it all over. And I said, hell no, bro. You are not deleting my stuff. No way, no how. Never, ever, Mr. Engineer Man. Put it in the cloud where it all belongs.
Keep it there, safe and sound.
Doc joins us for the racing report every Friday morning. I don't really want to talk too much about last week's race. There wasn't a whole lot to get to, but I did want to mention something that I noticed, and I thought it was kind of interesting, and it seems like something they're doing that's new. You know, you get the race, the driver introductions at the beginning of the race, obviously, and a lot of times they'll come out on a walkway or a catwalk or whatever, and they, you know, do a little spin and wave hi to the crowd and all this crap, and, you know, and they've got these weird cartoon versions that they show on TV, but this year I noticed for the first time, and maybe it's just me, but they're doing these pit crew introductions, and I only caught it because it's almost like in the NFL when you watch Sunday Night Football and they have like the defensive line and like, I'm so-and-so and I'm from this college, you know?
Yes,
and,
like, it's like that.
They're doing that with the pit crew, and I noticed because one of them was a former NFL player, and I said, wait a minute, did that guy just say he played for an NFL team? And is this something new that they're doing, Doc?
Actually, no, it's not. And you got to go all the way back to about 1993 to where this started. Hendrick Motorsports was looking for a way to you know, gain an edge, you know, whether on the track or in the pits. And so they were the first ones to hire a pit crew coordinator. And I'm going to murder his name here. His name is Andy Papathanasio.
Bless
you. That's close enough.
Close.
Yep. And close enough. And so they hired him to be a pit crew coordinator. And at the time, pit crews were like, you know, the guys who work on the engine, the mechanics and stuff.
Yeah.
And so he started viewing this, and he thought, you know, pit stops should be viewed as like, you know, an athletic endeavor, an athletic, you know, type event. So we started looking at, like, you know, college graduates from, like, football, you know, college football, college basketball,
guys,
college
wrestling.
Guys who
didn't make it into the NFL, that kind of stuff.
Yeah, guys who aren't going on to a pro career. And he started recruiting them, and, you know, within a year and a half, that paid off because, you know, by 1995, Jeff Gordon had the fastest pit crew by over a second over anybody on pit lane, and he ended up winning the 1995 his first championship, mostly because of how fast the Rainbow Warriors were. And so, you know, that's other teams started following their lead, and they would go recruit, you know, college athletes who just graduated or former pro athletes who still had some life in the tank. And they'd teach them how to change tires and put, you know, bigger guys putting gas in, teach them the basics of, you know, if there's some sheet metal bent, what you got to do to fix it. And boom, that's the evolution of a NASCAR crew has come to the point where right now they're even one guy down from when this all started, and they're still turning, you know, 9 and 10 second pit stops with four tires and gas. So that's basically a brief synopsis of how it started. But you have to, like I said, go all the way back to 1993. Hendrick had an idea. That idea paid off in a championship, in Jeff Gordon's first championship. Then you talk about, you know, quick brief hit from Vegas last week. Talk about the crews. You know, they do get in trouble sometimes, especially when a tire falls off, like the Chris Buescher car, how hard he hit the wall when that right front tire fell off. So the right front, the front tire changer and the jack band both suspended for 2 weeks for letting that tire fall off. They used to suspend the crew chief also, but then they realized the crew chief isn't the one changing the tire. Why are we suspending him? So he gets to stay on the box. This week they're at Phoenix. It's a 1 mile oval with a big dog leg as you come off of turn four, banking at 9 degrees of turn one and two. Turns 3 and 4 are 11 degrees, all pretty much similar to what lacrosse is at 11 degrees. William Byron won this race last year. Ross Chastain won the championship race last year right in front of champion Ryan Blaney. Qualifying record was set by Jimmy Johnson in 2015 at 146.3 miles an hour. Fantasy experts, they like Larson, Byron, and Blaney. When I filled mine out last night, you can't leave Chastain off your list. Reddick, Truex, and Hamlin also run well at this track. Our odds this week come to us via VegasInsider.com from the BetGM app. Larson at plus 600, Blaney at 700, Byron at 750, Chastain at 800, Hamlin at 900. Two parties highlight Doc's smoker calendar this weekend. Tomorrow afternoon, Henderson Motorsports Smoker at Timmer's 10 Mile Pub. Over 80 items in the Chinese raffle. Tip boards, Vegas boards, gun raffles. They caught a couple of cornhole board raffles.
Nice.
Cash prizes. Mike's DJ and MC service will provide the entertainment. Party starts at 5 p.m. Also tomorrow afternoon, the Gordon Noodleman Smoker supporting Travis Gordon and his sportsman and Joe Noodleman and his late model at Feature Sports Bar and Grill in West Salem. Gun raffles, baskets, tip boards, door prizes, free beer while it lasts, and much more. Good Times Entertainment provides the DJ for tomorrow afternoon. That party starts at 4 p.m. Now, to keep up to date on all the smokers, check out the Midwest Racing Smokers page on Facebook. And remember, folks, during smoker season, get out and support a local short track team. Doc's Race Report has been brought to you by our friends at County Materials on Empire Street in Holman. That is this week's Race Report.
Thank you very much, Doc. Always a pleasure. Racing Report each and every Friday morning.
That's interesting. I didn't know that about the...
I knew about the app, but I think the introduction part is the new part, I think. Because, like I said, I had never noticed that until, I think, last week. And I heard the guy say he was a former NFL player. And I said, what? Are they doing intros for the pit crew now?
Yeah. Cool.
We've got bad news, happy music coming up in a few. Visit rockmornings.com to get in touch with us.
Rock Mornings, Monday to Friday, 6 to 9.
You're about to enter a beautiful, exciting, wonderful new world.
A cockroach living in your nostril.
Now that's just nasty.
Add in some haven't pooped for 30 days.
Poop is raining from the ceilings. Poop.
And sprinkle in some hashtag Florida Man for flavor.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man quits his Burger King job, steals all of their chicken nuggets.
It's bad news.
Bad news.
With happy music.
Let's rock.
A Friday edition. What do we got?
Well, it's advertised as a truck that can go anywhere, but apparently it can't. Tesla's Cybertruck can survive machine gun fire, extraterrestrial terrain, and even the apocalypse, if you believe Elon Musk. However, a sandy beach proved too much for the $80,000 stainless steel toy. The Cybertruck met its match on California's Marina State Beach when it got stuck in the sand after illegally driving onto the beach inside the state park. Footage shot by a bystander shows the owner trudging across the beach as local firefighters help him out. They say the owner of the Tesla Cybertruck drove the vehicle onto the beach while going over a curb and a sidewalk and passed a sign that said no vehicles allowed.
Mm-hmm.
The Cybertruck soon got stuck on the beach. The fire department was able to move the vehicle after deflating the tires, enabling it to slowly roll back to safer land. The owner of the truck got a citation of nearly $300 for breaking the don't drive on the sand rule.
Big dummy.
Yep. If you want to be a part of history, get yourself to St. Louis next Thursday. A place called City Museum is hoping to break the world record for most people wearing underwear on their head. They've already have the world's largest pair of underwear.
What's the, so is it everyone gets in the one pair or everybody wears their own pair?
Actually, neither. They give you a pair. The current record for most people with underwear on their head is 270. That was set in Illinois in 2012. They're hoping to crush that. They only need 271 to break the record, but their goal is 314 because next Thursday is March 14th. 314, that's also Pi Day, as in the mathematical constant 3.14, and 314 is also the St. Louis area code. You don't need to bring your own pair of undies. Just show up next Thursday. They'll give you some underwear to put on your head.
You get to take them with you?
I don't know.
Are they serving pie afterwards?
They should.
Well, what the hell, man?
Pie Day?
This is ridiculous.
You of all people should know I would never in my life wear black silk underwear.
Never.
On my head.
Right.
I'm assuming it's just like a cotton brief.
I don't know the nature of the underwear. Just hope they're clean.
You would hope they are clean. Mm-hmm. If they're new.
Mm-hmm. Right. A man in Baltimore was stabbed with a can opener. When police got to the scene, they found a 57-year-old man stabbing a 49-year-old man in the head.
Like with a wine bottle opener with a corkscrew?
I don't know if that was just the pointed end of something you would open a bottle with.
Oh, like a bottle opener.
Officers apprehended the suspect. He's in police custody. The victim suffered minor non-life-threatening injuries. According to the investigation, the victim was waiting at a bus stop when he bumped into the victim. That led to a verbal altercation, and ultimately the suspect repeatedly stabbed the man with the bottle opener.
Where in the head?
I don't know. The skull, I'm guessing.
Man.
A Tennessee mother of five died after she had a Brazilian butt lift performed by a doctor in Miami, who, as it turns out, was allegedly not allowed to operate on patients, according to a lawsuit filed by the woman's family. Erica Russell traveled to the Seduction Cosmetic Center facility in Florida in 2021 to undergo the cosmetic procedure. During that procedure, her doctor, John Sampson, punctured her liver, her bladder, and her intestines with a tube used to remove fluid from the body. A little over 2 hours after the procedure began, Russell went into cardiac arrest and died. The lawsuit says her cause of death was determined to be pulmonary fat emboli and bleeding due to liposuction and bilateral gluteal augmentation surgery. Attorneys representing Russell's family said this guy, Samson, was not allowed to perform surgical procedures.
Yeah, I wonder why.
Right. And that the company had provided him with falsified paperwork saying that he had plastic and cosmetic privileges when, in fact, he did not.
Punishment should fit the crime on that one, Shaw. Mm-hmm. Let somebody go in there with a tube and puncture all his internal organs while they're trying to do a butt lift.
Stick it up the butt.
Yes. Mm-hmm. What the hell?
A mail carrier in California was assaulted in a seemingly unprovoked attack, all caught on video. Bruce Jennings was assaulted by a man with a decades-long criminal history that includes assault with a deadly weapon. Jennings said apparently this guy was upset that he did not have a package for him. Ooh. And that he was asking for it to be delivered to a vacant home where he was allegedly squatting. Surveillance video shows the suspect exchanging words with Jennings and then suddenly punching him in the back of the head. The suspect then reached for his pocket before throwing more punches that took Jennings to the ground. Prior to that, according to the guy who got assaulted, he's telling me that he could do me foul. I don't know what that means.
But you did him
foul.
He
said.
You did.
The guy's going to be okay. He says he will carry on with his deliveries.
So it's rain, it's sleet, it's snow, and face punches.
Face punches,
from this guy.
That is the sweetest package.
He just wanted to have his sweetest package, Shaw, and he didn't have it. Somebody's there to get the package, Shaw.
Well, a squatter is.
Yeah, a squatter wants his package, Shaw. Give him the package.
Somebody's there to get the package, Shaw.
Yeah, some guy is there. He doesn't live there.
Otherwise, he might get punched in the head.
Yeah.
In Atlanta, Georgia, the sheriff's office is warning people to be careful around certain bodies of water after an alligator charged at a deputy the other day. The deputy was assisting with a canine training session near a pond when he heard a hiss. A 7 to 9 foot alligator was in the water, its mouth open, and it chased after him. The deputy ran up an embankment and wasn't injured, but now the sheriff's office said it will be installing warning signs about alligators in the area.
Damn alligator bit my hand off.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, let the people know.
Yeah. Gator don't play no.
Gator don't play no shit.
It's like where they didn't tell the little old lady it was in the pond, and then she got ate.
Oh, gotta watch out for them gators. In fact, it is, Mr. Deputy.
You may be able to get away with this with Doug in the lunchroom, but not at your child's school. A Texas woman has been arrested after her son's alleged bully had to go to the hospital after consuming an intentionally mixed sports drink. The mother, Jennifer Lynn Rossi, mixed lemon, salt, and vinegar into a sports drink bottle to prevent her son's drink from being stolen at school by other students.
So the kid's drink normally gets stolen.
Yes.
And so she spiked it so that the person who stole it would drink it and get sick.
Yeah. Her 10-year-old son gave the bottle to another boy during gym class. He drank some of it, experienced nausea and a headache. Deputies were called. Although lemon, salt, and vinegar are non-toxic, this did lead to the victim being hospitalized for additional medical monitoring, but he was eventually discharged. When the principal contacted the mother, she admitted having intentionally mixed the contents of the drink after having heard from her son that the victim stole his drink and was bullying him. The son recounted that his drink went missing during recess the day before and said the victim told him he had it and kept bragging about it. He went home, told his mother what happened, and that's when she came up with the idea to prank the alleged bully, and the son simply did what he was told by his mother. She is charged with injury to a child, causing bodily injury.
Yeesh.
You can blame Boeing for missing bolts and airlines for jammed bathroom doors. But crazy passengers can also cause problems for planes, making travel miserable for the rest of us. A flight in China was delayed for more than 4 hours the other day after a passenger threw coins into the plane's engine. The idea was that they were lucky coins.
Oh, my God.
In a video on Chinese social media, a flight attendant is seen questioning the passenger who allegedly threw the coins. The passenger was arrested, and the airline, China Southern Airlines, says they were able to retrieve the coins, and they completed a thorough check before the plane was cleared to fly again.
How did he get access to the engine? Like, did they board differently? Because, like, when you get on an airplane now, you're going through the tunnel, and the tunnel goes right to the door and right by the cockpit, and there's no, like, there's a little bit you can see out and maybe, like, catch the wing, but, like, how did he get...
I don't know if they board differently in China. I'm not sure.
Man.
But anyway, the airline put a message out on social media acknowledging that there have been incidents of people throwing coins at planes, apparently for good luck, and they warned people to knock it off.
Stop that.
Not a wishing well.
Not a wishing well.
A Florida woman facing burglary and battery charges after she broke into her ex-boyfriend's home and threw Sprite at him, as well as pickled pork juice on his sofa.
Oh,
hell is pickled pork juice?
It's from the jar, the big jar at the bar with the pickled feet and the pickled oinkers and the tails and all that stuff. Yes. Yeah, we talked about that.
When police got there, they said the woman was holding a bottle of Sprite outside the home, which she then flung at the victim, her ex-boyfriend, and hit him with it. Reddick began shouting at the victim and continuously trying to fight him as the deputy tried to separate the pair. A doorbell camera caught the woman taking a spare key from under the doormat and entering the home. She went in, started throwing things, breaking things. The victim showed up at the home and confronted her. She started shouting at him and throwing pickled pork of the pickled pork.
Why did she have all that?
So she had the jar and she was taking the pork out and throwing it, and then she was
splashing the juice around.
Oh, God. That's no wonder she's the ex.
She was arrested and taken to jail for battery, property damage, and burglary.
Handy. You got that handy at your house, huh?
A big old jar.
Maybe she worked at the bar and she brought it home thinking this is going to be, I'm going to solve all my problems.
And to be an astute criminal these days, it's good to have a strong recollection of Hollywood's classic films. Two women in Ohio have been arrested after they pulled a Weekend at Bernie's earlier this week. They propped an 80-year-old dead man up in their car and then went to a bank's drive-thru where they withdrew $900 from his account. It worked. They weren't relatives, but they did live with the man, and the bank had previously allowed them to take money out as long as he was with them. They clearly didn't notice the guy was no longer alive. The women then dumped the man's body off at a hospital and sped off. Eventually, the cops caught up with them, questioned them, and then arrested them. They told police they found the man dead inside the home earlier that day, although his cause of death is still under investigation.
Doesn't anyone realize he's dead?
Right? No, apparently not.
If he's in the car with us, they'll never know.
Right? Just prop him up there. Put some sunglasses on him.
Well, they had a whole rigging system, too.
Yes.
With ropes and stuff like that.
Pulleys.
So that they could move him. They didn't have to be right next to him.
Drive
the his arm go up and down. Yeah.
I don't think they went to quite that length, but.
I'm not taking a dead body.
I'm
to
just
the drive-thru.
Calling some. No. Mm-mm.
I'll wear a mask. Go to the drive-thru.
Not propping up a dead body?
No. Florida women. Florida?
Yeah. Oh,
yeah. Florida. Bad news, happy music. Thank you, Shaw. Talk to you on Monday. Blah, 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 blah. Procedural wide. Shaw's out, bitches. News. You've been news. Boo, 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 boo.
So, Caitlin Clark tonight? Is that what you said, Shaw?
Tonight at 5:30, they'll play Penn State. And then if they win, they play again on Saturday. And if they win, they play in the championship for the Big Ten tournament on Sunday.
All right. Best of luck to her. Enjoy your time.
Thank you.
In front of the television without me around.
He's all alone for the weekend. Shaw.
I could use a friend. Rock Mornings, Brian and Gene.
Quiet.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw. Call.
Hello.
Email.
I tried emailing you.
Text. So many ways to check in with us.
Check, check.
We rely on you guys for traffic updates, requests, and all sorts of other stuff.
Check this out.
Email earlier from Doug, the birthday boy, wanted to hear some tunes for his birthday, whether it was Godsmack, Slash, Kid Rock, Dirty Honey. It did the Kid Rock. You're welcome. Happy birthday, dude.
Happy birthday.
Thanks to my buddy Mark, who texted in. Let me know that the game I was looking for, Tempest.
So we were talking about retro video games.
Today is retro video game day.
And that was one of the ones you remembered but couldn't think of the name of. Tempest.
Speaking of retro video game.
Yeah.
Day. Chad sent me a message on Facebook, included some photos, said, definitely my day on the retro video game day. And he's got, I said, is that your basement? And he said, yeah, my man cave.
What systems he's got? All of them?
You
got
to come look at this. So he's got the Simpsons game. This is like a full-size arcade-style game. The Simpsons. I don't even know. Is that like a Mickey Mouse stool or something? Or is that Animaniacs? Looks like he's got like a... Is that Jordy Nelson back there? A little Jordy Nelson cut. Look at all those Funko Pops. He's got a whole bunch of Funko Pops.
A lot of Funko
Look at this thing.
What?
We got the Turtles. He's got 1944. Look at all that.
Look at all this stuff.
I know. I kind of want to hang out with Chad. Yeah. Crazy. Thank you, Chad. Jesse texted in and said, was that a quote from Double Impact? Yes. The Jean-Claude Van Damme movie where he plays twin brothers. One of them is... Their parents get killed. One of them gets taken in by a former bodyguard for the parents and is raised in, I think, Hollywood, California. And rich, successful.
Okay.
The other one becomes sort of like a criminal in Hong Kong. And the guy...
And then what?
Well, then... They have the rights to their parents' fortune and all this other stuff, so they have to get together and fight back against the criminals that took it from their parents. And the one guy has silk underwear, and the girlfriend gets confused, pulls the old switcheroo. The girlfriend of the criminal, Jean-Claude Van Damme, starts making out with the other Jean-Claude Van Damme, which is not her boyfriend.
No way.
And then the other boyfriend shows up and knocks his ass out. And then he complains to her, you, of all people, should know that I would never wear in my life black silk underwear. And yes, that is a quote from Double Impact.
Oh, boy.
James wanted to hear from, James from Altoona wanted to hear some Static X. We did that. Thank you, James and Altoona. Appreciate it. Devin wants to hear some Iron Maiden. Try to get to that after 9. Carol wants to hear some System of a Down. Also, Chris texted in for retro video games. Sinistar was a badass video game, he said. Mm.
I'm unfamiliar with that one.
All those games you grew up with. Badass games, whether it's Contra or Tecmo Bowl.
Cool.
I know, right? Thank you for all the correspondence. Good to talk to you guys. Have a great weekend. We'll be back on Monday.